Napoleon ran along, honey, I had pebbles everywhere. Adapted by Mickey Mathis, illustrated by Francesco Evermani and Giuliano Priori. One morning at sunny salon, the phone rang. It was Timmy calling from his apple orchard to say he would be late for his haircut. He had been picking apples when his ladder fell over. Now he couldn't get down. I'm kind of stuck at the moment, he said. And I mean really stuck up a tree. We'll be right there, Sunny said. Don't move. Sunny and her best friend Splatter and Fox jumped into the land and headed for Timmy's orchard. His ladder had broken when it fell, so Sunny, Splatter, and Fox tied together some hairnets to make a fake safety net to catch Timmy. Timmy was back on the ground in no time. Thanks so much. What can I do to repay you? Yes, you don't have to repay us. Timmy, Sunny replied. Friends help each other. But Timmy wanted to do something nice for Sunny, Fox, and Blair. He gave them a bushel of apples. Back at the salon, the girls enjoyed the tasty fruit. They had nearly finished the apples when Timmy brought another to bushels. And there's plenty more where those came from, he said. Happy crunching. The next morning, Timmy delivered more apples. And more the day after that. And the day after that. And the day after that. The salon turned into a chain fruit stand. Blair exclaimed, customers couldn't even get inside. Blair and Fox wanted to tell Timmy to stop bringing apples, but it makes him so happy to give them to us, Sunny said. She couldn't hurt Timmy's feelings. Fox had an idea. They could take the apples back to the orchard. The friends stuffed the apples into the clam pan, but as soon as Sunny started to dry, the fruit spilled out the back. There were just too many apples, so they took them back to the salon. When Timmy finally came for his haircut, the salon was so full of apples, they couldn't open the door. Sunny had to work in the glam van. I had no idea I brought you so many apples, Timmy said. After Sunny cut Timmy's hair, she turned on the hair dryer. Suddenly, the van smelled like apple pie. Some of the apples had gotten stuck in the dryer. The delicious smell gave Sunny an idea. We'll hold an apple festival right here at the salon and invite the whole town. The friends made apple sauce, apple butter, apple juice, and apple pie. There were apple-themed games, decorations, and music. Sunny even styled her hair in a super sweet apple bow. This is one for the style files, she said. Thanks to Timmy's delicious apples, everyone had a wonderful time at the first ever Friendly Falls Apple Festival. We couldn't have done any of this without your apples, Sunny told Timmy. When life hands you apples, she said, make apple pie, then.
Thanks for watching. Stall that like button and subscribe, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.